Hello friends, my name is Chinmay Deshpande. I am from Department of Electrical Engineering. Today we are going to discuss about a topic from unit Solution of Linear Simultaneous Equation. The topic is second iterative method which is used to solve linear simultaneous equation, that is Gauss-Seidel iterative method. So here also let us consider three linear simultaneous equations after partial pivoting. So please remember, for Gauss-Jacobi method and for Gauss-Seidel method also, we have to do a partial pivoting. Let us consider equation as a11 x1 plus a12 x2 plus a13 x3 equal to b1, a21 x1 plus a22 x2 plus a23 x3 equal to b2, a31 x1 plus a32 x2 plus a33 x3 equal to b3. Now from equation number 1, we have to write equation for x1, which will be equal to 1 upon a11, b1 minus a12, x2 minus a13, x3. From equation number 2, we have to write the equation for x2, which will be equal to 1 upon a22 into bracket b2 minus a21 x1 minus a23 x3. And similarly, from equation number 3, we will be writing equation for x3, which is equal to 1 upon a33 into bracket b3 minus a31 x1 minus a32 x2. Let us assume that we have an initial approximation x1 of 0 equal to x2 of 0 and x3 of 0, which is equal to 0. So this 0 indicates that this is a value of initial approximation. So how to find it out first iteration? Please remember, here we have used equation 4, 5 and 6 only here. But the thing is that here this 1 indicates first iteration. In that, instead of x2 and x3, we have to write x2 of 0 and x3 of 0. So this will be your first equation. Now while determining second equation, x2 of 1, instead of putting here x1 of 0, what we have to do? Whatever answer we will get here in the first equation, that is x1 of 1, we have to put it here. x3 of 0 will be as it is. And while calculating x3 of 1, what we have to do? Whatever answer we will get it here in a previous equations, we have to put it. That is, this will be your x1 of 1 and this will be your x2 of 1. So for iteration r plus 1th, we are going to write it as, here it will be rr. Here this answer will be substituted here. And for calculating your third, we have to substitute whatever values we are getting in equation number 1 and 2. So the question might be asked, what is the comparison between Gauss-Seidel and Gauss-Jacobi method? So if you observe, the main difference is that in case of Gauss-Jacobi method, we are using only x10, x20 and x30. So let me open that topic also, which is nothing but your Gauss-Jacobi method. If you remember, this is the equation of Gauss-Jacobi method, which is already we have seen in the previous video. So let me take it here for your information. So if I take it, let me take it here so that we can compare both the equations. We can compare here both the equations. So if you see, this is nothing but your Gauss-Seidel equation that we have discussed right now, and this is nothing but your Gauss-Jacobi equation. If you see, here we are using RR. You can take R equal to 0. So here you will get x1 of 1, x2 of 1, x3 of 1. But in case of your Gauss-Seidel method, whatever answer we are getting it here in the first, we are using it in the next equation. So if you compare these two, what kind of comparison is there? What you will observe here? The main difference is that in case of Gauss-Seidel method, the latest value of xyz is used to find next value of xyz. Whereas in case of Gauss-Jacobi method, same values of xyz are obtained in the one iteration is used for finding the next value of xyz. So if you see, the convergence method or convergence is a less or slow in case of Gauss-Jacobi method. Means what? Suppose by solving one set of equation by Gauss-Seidel method, if you are getting answer at the end of fifth iteration, then it will take more iterations to solve same equation by Gauss-Jacobi method. Let's say 8th or 10th, that depends upon equations. Then if you see this Gauss-Jacobi, now we are talking about Gauss-Jacobi. Please remember, we are not talking about any other method. So if you see Gauss method, this is a mistake here basically. Gauss-Jacobi is not a direct method. This is also iterative method. Okay, or indirect method. Gauss-Seidel is also, if you see, it will be what? It will be your iterative or indirect method. Now, the next question is, why Gauss-Seidel method is better as compared to that of Jacobi method? Because since the current values of unknown at each stage of iteration are used in the proceeding to the next stage of iteration, the convergence, that is nothing but the rate with which we will get the correct answer, the convergence of a Gauss-Seidel method will be more, or you can say it is rapid as compared to that of Gauss-Jacobi method. So this is what is the derivation that we have seen for Gauss-Seidel method. The question might be asked in a theory, explain Gauss-Seidel iterative method, give its derivation. So thank you for watching this video. If you have any doubt, please feel free to ask any questions. Thank you once again.